I mean, I looked at see a lot of intensity, flying 11 hats to the ball defensively and offensively, just executing and making sure we're doing our jobs.
I hope to see us execute every play the best we can, be competitive throughout the whole game, and just give ourselves an opportunity to win at the end of the game.
Opposing coaches' pregame comments as the Jackrabbits and Scorpions square off at Ray Moore Stadium. The Jackrabbits come out loaded for bear, grinding out big gains and establishing their ground game, first of Lataliava's 23 carries on the night. Fullback Nahasi Moala breaks a tackle at the 40 and crosses midfield before the senior two-way starter is dragged down by Hesperia outside linebacker Samari Jones-Griffin, 23. 49. We used to call this the belly series. Quarterback Lataliava rides the fullback, reads the defense, and keeps a gain of 15 to the 35. Victor Valley's opening series grinds deep into Scorpions territory. Nahasi Moala, strong second effort again. But the Jackrabbits are about to begin committing a series of penalties that throw a monkey wrench into the gears of the offensive game plan. The Rabbits actually score the game's first touchdown. Lataliava cuts through the Scorpions' defense like hot lava, but the 11-yard scoring play is called back due to a holding penalty. The Scorpions' defense stiffens. Inside linebacker Manuel Bowen with the sack here. Manuel Bowen, a 5'7", 150-pound senior. Hesperia successfully halts Victor Valley's game-opening drive and will take over on downs. Hesperia's initial first down comes on Hayden LaVar's completion to Kenneth Russell. The Scorpions quarterback is a 6'1", 175-pound junior. Hayden LaVar's completes 10 of 22 passes this game for 180 yards and two touchdowns. The second of Hayden LaVar's completions, again to Kenneth Russell, the first of those two scoring passes. Kenneth Russell takes the quick pitch and sprints 63 yards to pay dirt. Kenneth Russell, 5'7", 160-pound senior wide receiver. 7-0 Scorpions, 4:47 shows on the Ray Moore Stadium first quarter clock. Victor Valley resumes its successful ground game attack. Lataliava, first down yardage from the 20 to the 33. Again, the Jackrabbits' drive crosses midfield and penetrates deep into Scorpions' territory. A 33-yard gain by Lataliava, who rushes for well over 100 yards before the stats are reduced to 56 yards gained due to 73 yards lost in sacks and bad snaps. Penalties and broken plays, combined with some excellent defensive plays, plague this second Jackrabbits possession. 52 for the Scorpions is senior inside linebacker Joe Mock, who led Hesperia tacklers with 9 stops in the 30-27 loss to Atalanta. Defensive end Darius Glover plays a big part in impeding this Jackrabbits drive, the 6'6", 236-pound senior with the sack. Darius Glover is the Scorpions' sacks leader with 4 two games in. Hesperia gets their first turnover on Victor Valley's next possession. Kenneth Russell winds up with the fumble recovery after the pass completion. This Scorpions' possession ends with a missed field goal. The Jackrabbits respond with another drive that takes them into Scorpions' territory. Watch 52, Isaac Ugapo. Key block on this play, Isaiah Nixon carries to midfield. Same play that the 5'9", 181-pound senior will score on just before halftime. The drive is halted by more Scorpions' outstanding defensive play. Samari Griffin, the sack, here. Samari Griffin, 5'10", 175-pound, outside linebacker, a junior. Hesperia's second touchdown follows. Hayden LaVar's hits tight end Javion Harris, who hauls it in. The 6'1", 190-pound senior turns it on and turns it into a 57-yard scoring play. At 3.5 minutes before halftime, it is 14-0 Scorpions. At this point, the Jackrabbits respond with a successful scoring drive. This is but one of a number of key third down carries by the senior fullback, Nahasi Moala, picking up the first down on a 3rd-and-6 here. Isaiah Nixon caps the drive with the touchdown from 15 yards out, getting outside after key blocks by the pulling Isaac Ugapo and Ulysses Munoz and Nahasi Muwala. The Jackrabbits have sliced the Scorpions' lead in half. It is 14-7 Hesperia at the intermission. The next scoring does not come until under 3 minutes show in the third quarter. Sophomore Omar Olivares boots the 29-yard field goal, and the visitors mount a 17-7 lead. Latuliava responds with the biggest play of the night, retrieving the kickoff at the 20, cutting to the outside and splitting a pair of defenders, getting a solid block from Nahasi Muwala, racing the remainder of the way on the newly resurfaced artificial turf, Raymore Stadium Field, untouched, 80 yards to kickoff return for a touchdown, and Victor Valley is right back in it, 17-14 the score, and we enter fourth quarter action. Joseph Pace previews the game-winning touchdown on this play selection. The slant pattern, quarterback Latuliava reveals to Daily Press scribe Jose Quintero that JoJo calls that play the bacon. The senior signal caller does his own fair share of bringing home the bacon this fourth quarter carry preceding the game-winning touchdown. Latuliava demonstrating artful open field running, darting back and carrying into the Scorpions' red zone. The game winner reveals another clutch performance by Latuliava and JoJo, Joseph Pace. This is 4th and 8. The Rabbits backed up to the 29. Completion of the slant pitch, and Joseph Pace races past defenders into the end zone. It is early in the fourth quarter. 8:15 remains to be played. Part and parcel of Victor Valley preserving the fourth quarter lead are key carries by their senior fullback, Nahasi Muwala. Second effort carries that enable the Jackrabbits to maintain possession on crucial third down plays. And, of course, equally important are the two fourth quarter pass interceptions by sophomore Turion White, who turns off the light in Scorpions' late game possessions. The second of the picks come at the 3 minute mark of the game. The Jackrabbits succeed at running out the clock thereafter. Victor Valley's victory gives Desert Sky League teams another measure of accomplishment in seeing a DSL team defeat a Mojave River League opponent. Only Adelanto had also succeeded in topping an MRL foe in the four earlier encounters between MRL and DSL teams in the first 2 weeks of the season. The Jackrabbits' next game, the battle for the bell at Apple Valley. As for the Scorpions, their next task is a journey to Alta Loma. This online sports report presented by Midway Home Solutions in Victorville, family owned and operated and serving the high desert since 1961. Terry Kurtz here, throwing you an invitation to catch the 30-minute action highlights program, your High Desert Sports Report, showing daily on the Victor Valley Television Network, victorvalleytv.com.